Why COVID-19 is so hard to treat and long COVID happens. A new study suggests that long COVID might be associated with a unique infectious profile by the coronavirus. This profile might also be the reason why doctors find it difficult to treat the disease at every turn. According to the US CDC, post-COVID conditions are a range of new, returning, or ongoing health problems experienced over 4 weeks after initial infection. These conditions may be experienced as well by individuals who were asymptomatic during infection. Long COVID symptoms include headaches, loss of smell or taste, chest pain, pounding heart, and difficulty breathing. Multi-organ effects such as autoimmune disorders and multi-system inflammatory syndrome may happen too. Because the coronavirus can send the immune system into overdrive, many organs can sustain damage long after infection, and scientists don't know exactly when these effects may last. At Trinity College Dublin, researchers conducted a comprehensive review to learn more about COVID-19 and SARS-CoV-2's infectious profile. Scientists know that respiratory pathogens follow one of the two common patterns during infection. For low pathogenic human coronaviruses, the viruses usually stay in the upper respiratory tract and cause cold-like symptoms. For high pathogenic causal agents of SARS and ARDS, the viruses normally settle in the lower respiratory tract. The team reviewed the details of COVID-19 pathophysiology, its various phenotypes, and the humoral and cellular response levels of hosts. Animal and experimental models were applied and results were compared to data from COVID patients. The obvious was the similarities between COVID-19 and respiratory failure due to other infections. However, evidence unveiled multiple distinct features showing COVID-19 is a new disease entity. It consists of discrete signatures that totally separate it from many respiratory diseases like the common cold and influenza. First, COVID-19 could settle in both upper and lower respiratory tracts, practically attacking whole lungs. This kind of invasion would cause immune cells to battle the coronavirus in the entirety of the organ. Second, with immune cells fighting a new pathogen, inflammatory responses may rise to disturbing levels. Although inflammation is necessary, inflammation against COVID is not similar to the response directed to other similar viruses. Third, aggressive inflammation was detected in animal and experimental models, though the mechanics in the human body might differ. This immune behavior might be a unique dysregulation of the immune system, causing it to mismanage the fight against COVID-19. It might explain long COVID and severe lung damage after infection. The study was published in The Lancet Respiratory Medicine. Thank you.